Well, the 710 freeway for sure. Challenges in the Civic Center still exist. On the YWCA site, although I think that seemed to be going in the right direction. And All Saints Church, a very controversial addition, is under discussion, which is on the other side of the Civic Center.
Well, and I think back in the 70s, when the whole thrust of redevelopment was to revitalize the economy of the city, bring economic revitalization to bear, it was really the commercial districts that were looked at. So Old Pasadena, the Civic Center, around to South Lake, and then stretching out towards East Colorado and up to North Lake. I think all of those continue to be places in transition, with Old Pasadena in some ways being the most secure because it's been the greatest success. But again, the retail mix is starting to turn over, more housing is coming in, it's entering a new generation of Old Pasadena. And so I think the pressure for economic development in the commercial districts, where there are a lot of great historic buildings, continues to mean that there are battles to be waged.
Well, new development in terms of upgrading the density as is currently permitted under current ordinances continues to impact historic residences in the proximity to this central district, and usually again for condominiums or mixed-use development of one kind or another. I think, too, something that's little recognized or understood is that in spite of the vaunted success of Old Pasadena, every time in the past 20 years or so, there's been a change of tenant, a change of ownership of a historic building in Old Pasadena, there's typically more historic fabric lost. Maybe not on the exterior, but on the interior, where once there were complete historic commercial interiors, say a jewelry store or some other kind of business, that's all wiped out. And so we have lost incrementally over this time some important aspects of the historic Pasadena.
We have. The whole issue of new development in historic areas, if the new development blends appropriately with its surroundings, and that's an issue that's been under discussion for the last 30 years. And even though I think the city has moved slowly in the right direction on that, certainly not always, and those battles are still going to continue. And the quality of new construction and again, how it blends with its surrounding neighbors, those issues are going to continue. And I know we'll still lots of debates about those.
And by definition, new construction is typically not going to necessarily be harmonious with regard to mass and scale and so on, all the reasons why bigger buildings are built, because that meets the higher economic expectation of the developer.
And if you look often, unfortunately, at the care and the devotion not only of the architects but of all the craftspeople and all the builders and every concrete mason, stone mason, woodworker on the historic buildings who took such pride in what they created, as simple as it might have been, I think unfortunately we've lost a lot of that pride in workmanship or even the ability to pay for the kind of craftsmanship that were put into the early buildings. They just are prohibitively expensive to dream of building today. So we might be able to appreciate new modern design from a design perspective, but in terms of materials and craftsmanship, it's rare, I'd say, to see that level of detail executed in newer buildings today.